हाय, गुड मॉर्निंग। आर यू बोथ आर क्लियर? Are you able to both are clear? All of you? Here? Good morning, everyone. Prakash, Padma, Pravalika, good morning. Good morning, all of you. Right. So here, all of you, welcome to An Academy. Let's crack it. Are you guys ready to crack? Yes, be ready to crack. So we'll be learning on the India's largest platform, that is An Academy. So India's largest online platform, you can say, right? You can compare An Academy with other platforms, then you can understand how An Academy is superior to other platforms, you can say, right? Like that. So namaste Pravalika, right? Had your breakfast, all of you? Had your tea, tiffin, breakfast done? Yes or no? No breakfast? Okay, don't worry, we'll be having a good breakfast now for this one. Only coffee? Okay, very good, Sunny. Good morning. Right. So here, this ESC part we are studying, that Masonry structures and earthquake resistant design of structures. What we have seen till now, if you just remember? We have just seen which one? We have just seen the PYQs of this ESC, na? Is that no? Coffee pee le khe li apne. No, I did not take coffee, only water I have taken. I don't take coffee tea, only milk I will take, Abhishek. Okay. So the perfect study partner for GATE and ESC will be your An Academy only, you can say. Juice, no juice also, no juice. After the class I will be taking, right. So here, these are all the GATE 2021 rankers from Civil Engineering An Academy. These are 2021 GATE rankers in Environmental Science and Engineering from An Academy, right? Ragi Malti is also after the class. Now during the class, nothing will be there, right? Okay. Right. So, for taking milk, there is nothing related to age, no? Is that no? So, these are all the benefits you are getting whenever you are taking the plus subscription, right? So within this circle, whatever the benefits given, these are all the benefits you will be getting when you are taking the plus subscription. And outside the circle you are having, now, these are all the additional benefits you will be getting. Additional means what? Along with this plus subscription, you will be getting these additional benefits when you are taking Iconic subscription, right? Minor project in BTech Civil. Project means many suggestions can be given. A small design you can take, right? A small water tank design you can take, okay? Sunny, a small rectangular water tank design, like that, a cooling tower design you can take. Shravan, good morning. So like that you can take anyone, right? If it is in-house project, if you are going to industry, there they will be allocating the work to you. Or if you are doing on your own in the college, under the faculty, you take a building, multi-story building design in the STAD Pro, like that. And a water tank design in the STAD Pro, or normal conventional design. Like that you can say, right? Any type of this design, apart from the normal design element, you take slightly some other new element, right? Silos, chimneys, design, like that. That kind of project you can take up, okay? For mini project, right? So these are all the new batches, you can say. Which material they will provide, sir? Hard copy or printed? Yeah, theory material and all these things they'll be providing, right? They'll be providing this additional material for you. Actually, they thought of providing the hard copy initially, but because of this COVID situation, they could not provide this hard copy at present, I think so. Mostly the soft copies they'll be providing, right? Okay, So this accelerate batch for which one? The general studies, right? All of you, general studies, there is a separate batch started, right? Along with the technical, general studies batch also started, right? These are all the faculty teaching in the general studies, right? Saurabh Kumar, Saurabh Thakur, Umamesh, Aman, Sayad, Rajat, Raju Singh. So these are all the faculty teaching for general studies of ESC, you can say, okay? All of you. And a technical, civil, KP sir, myself and Prank Kulkarni sir will be teaching, okay? Right. So whenever you are subscribing for the plus courses or iconic courses, right? So you have to use the referral code as RP Civil. When you are using the RP Civil code, 10% discount plus credits if you are utilizing, for the 10% discount you will be getting, okay? Right. Iconic subscription, same. RP Civil code 10% discount and credits also for the 10% discount you will be getting, okay? So these are all the combat events got over already. And this bumper offer, right? Again, this offer. So this offer of which one? 3 months extra plus value, okay? Yeah, I'll be starting that design from May 5th onwards. Right? That new batch is started by KP sir. Is teaching the new batch, na? Yes or no? Okay? So the new batch is started or not? Yes or no? New batch is started or not? May 5th onwards, right? There, I'll be starting the steel structures, okay? Prakash, after the structure analysis is completed, I'll be starting the steel structures. Immediately after the steel structures, I'll be going for which one? RCC and PSC, okay? Don't worry. Immediately after structure analysis, the design subjects only I'll be starting, okay? I have to make PDF only and present tomorrow by online. Okay, you have to make only PDF, okay? Then you can find it anywhere. You can just to find the designs anywhere. Google is there now already. You can find it in Google. If you are having any doubt, you can just contact me, right? Like that. So here, these are all the new test series, you can say. And these are all the people who got benefited from which one? This Unacademy Combat. Right. So this May 5th onwards. May 5th onwards, right? May 5th onwards, what you are having, right? May 5th onwards, we are having. No, it is for GATE and ESC together, I'll be discussing, right? GATE and ESC together, I'll be discussing, right? Both point of view, I'll be discussing, okay? No. Whenever we are discussing the subject, GATE and ESC point of view, both point of view, we'll be discussing, Prakash, right? Not only GATE, not only ESC, right? Because both examinations are having the same syllabus, no? Yes or no? Sometimes if you just observe, in GATE, you'll be finding good kind of questions. Sometimes you'll be finding good kind of questions in ESC, right? So it is better you prepare for both, whatever the examination you are writing, right? Is that clear, Prakash? Whatever the examination you write, it is better you prepare GATE point of view and ESC point of view, right? Both you prepare, right? That is better. So May 5th onwards, that a new batch will be started by these three faculty only, right? So which one? May 5th. So KP sir will be starting one subject. Myself, KP sir is starting hydrology. Myself will be starting which one? Steel structures, right? Either on 5th I will be starting, or on 9th I will be starting this subject, okay? Is that clear, everyone? Right? No. So these are all the subjects I will be taking in Unacademy Plus platform. And 5th May onwards, that new batch will be there. KP sir, Praveen Kulkarni sir, and RP sir, right? Myself will be starting this English batch mainly, right? We will be teaching mainly in which one? English. Yeah, both will be concentrating, right? Both will be discussing, right? Nothing will be leaving, okay? Don't worry. Yeah, everybody. Yes, steel I will be starting, right? Steel I will be starting from this point onwards, right? 5th May onwards, this new batch is starting now. KP sir will be starting hydrology. Praveen Kulkarni sir, anyway, strength of materials. And RP sir, myself will be starting the steel structures, right? In this new batch, okay? Already KP sir has shared those links in the group, na? Those information in the group, na? Yes or no? Right. So these are all the plus courses already done by me. Now at present, this full length course on structural analysis is going on. After that full length course on structural analysis, I will be starting the steel structures. Okay. May 9th to which one? 5th June. Right. In that batch only, which is going to start on 5th May. And full length course on this reinforced concrete structures, it will be starting on which one? 6th June to 30th June, you can say, right? Like that, okay? Now, so coming to this, we have discussed this PVQs, no? Do you remember all of you? All these PVQs of masonry structures and earthquake resistant design of structures we have seen, na? Yes or no, isn't it? Now, what we are going to see is so if you just observe part 4, that it is not PVQs, the PVQs got already over ESC, masonry and earthquake resistant design, right? Masonry and earthquake resistant design both together we will be discussing here, right? Like that. Now, here, whenever you consider the masonry structures, what are the main advantages of this masonry structure if you just observe, all of you? What are the main advantages of this masonry structure? Is there any farm work required? First advantage is what? No farm work. So is there any farm work required for brick masonry construction or stone masonry construction, all of you? For concrete construction, you require farm work, isn't it? All of you, for which type of construction you require farm work? For concrete construction only you require which one? Farm work, right? Yes or no? But for this one, is it possible to have, is it required to provide any farm work, or without any farm work we can construct these masonry walls, right? Whenever you are having these masonry walls, any farm work is required, or directly we can construct them, all of you? Any farm work is required, or directly we can construct them, right? Directly we can construct these bricks, na? Yes or no? In YouTube, it may not be possible always. In YouTube, it is not possible. So, on special classes, I'll be taking, don't worry, right? Those things I'll be taking on the special classes, don't worry, okay? Right. So, no farm work is required, right? That is advantage, na? So, the cost of farm work will be reducing on at all of you. Whenever farm work is not useful, means the cost corresponding to farm work will be reducing, obviously, or not? Yes, that cost will be reducing, right? Greater flexibility in terms of plan forms. Now tell me, is there any difficulty in which type of plan you are forming? Do you need to form the regular plan like this only? Like this, this is one room, this is one room, this is one room, this is one room. So, is it required to plan in this format only, or you can form the shape, the plan can be of any shape you can say. Do you have any problem in constructing the plan of this shape, all of you? Is there any difficulty in construction of masonry using this plan view? Is there any difficulty? Any shape is okay or not? Any plan shape is or plan form is okay or not? All of you. Any plan shape or any plan form is okay. Do you need to have only regular one? No need to have any regular one, right? So it can be of which one? More flexibility you can have, right? More flexibility you can have, right? Like that. Okay? Now, place a dual role, that is functional and structural. What is the meaning of this structural, you can say? Yes, yes, no columns will be there, right? Sometimes we can provide columns, sometimes we don't provide columns also, right? Generally in masonry, no columns are there, right? No columns are there, right? Yes. Pure masonry structure, no columns will be there, obviously, right? Now, structural means what? Structural role means what? It will be resisting the loads or not, all of you? What is the meaning of this structural role? It will be resisting the loads or not? Yes, it will be resisting the loads, obviously, right? Functional means what? Functional means what? Can we say it is a creation of rooms? So, no. Yes, only vertical walls we are having, right? Only vertical walls we are having. On the top, what you can have? Slab you can have, right? Slab you can have, right? On the top, what you can have? Slab you can have, right? That slab can be of anyone, you can say, right? Any roof, right? So, intended to use, right? Functional means what? Intended to use. For which purpose mainly? It is the creation of these rooms is the main function, na? Isn't it? What is the purpose of this masonry? What is the function of this masonry wall? All of you, function of masonry wall is what? Creation of the rooms is the main function or not? All of you. creation of rooms is the main function other, right? Suppose if you are just constructing one column here, right? If you are just constructing this, right? If you are just constructing these columns, the rooms will be created inside or rooms will not be created inside? If you are just constructing the columns, slabs, rooms will be created or rooms will not be created? Rooms will not be created, no? Only by means of this brick masonry wall or stone masonry wall or whatever it is, a masonry wall, the rooms will be created or not. Without these walls, without these brick masonry walls, can you able to create the rooms? It is impossible to create the rooms, right? So the main purpose will be what? Creation of this rooms, right? Creation of which one? Rooms are what you can say, separations, right? Or what else you can write? Separations. And privacy purpose, right? Kitchen, whenever it is a kitchen, that will be created, right? Yes, na? Corresponding outer walls will be created, right? More openings will be there, right? If it is a bedroom, less openings will be there, right? Like that. So, can we provide a bedroom with more opening and kitchen with more closing? Is it possible? Bedroom with more opening and kitchen with more closing, can we provide like that or reverse we have to provide, right? It is in the reverse manner, na? How it is possible? Only with the help of this masonry we can do it, na? Yes, only with the help of masonry we can do it like that, okay? Now, economy. Economy, what is the meaning of economy? Cost of construction is lesser, no? Cost is lesser, right? Which cost is lesser if you just observe? Which cost is lesser? Materials cost is lesser. And construction cost is also lesser. Isn't it? Material cost is lesser. Obviously, which one? Construction cost is lesser, right? Suppose if you wanted to construct 1 cubic meter of concrete and 1 cubic meter of brick masonry, which one will be costing lesser, tell me? So that rates will be changing according to that. Okay, every year the rates will be changing. You have to get them from which one? CPWD, right? Central Public Works Department website, you will be getting them, right? Yes or no? Right. Now, materials cost will be lesser and construction cost also will be lesser. Isn't it all of you? And which one is easy to construct? Normal steel structures and concrete structures are easy to construct or masonry structures are easy to construct? Tell me. Which one are easy to construct? Normal steel and RCC structures are easy to construct or masonry structures are easy to construct? Tell me. Which one are easy to construct? Masonry structures are easy to construct, obviously, no? Masonry structures are easy to construct, obviously, or not? Yes, masonry structures are easy to construct, obviously. And whenever they are easy to construct, means, do you require any technical skills? Do you require any skilled labor? Or you don't require any skilled labor? You don't require any skilled labor, right? Masonry is only easy to construct and material cost is also easy to construct. No skilled labor is required, no extra money we need to spend, right? Cost of material is also lesser only, no? Yes. And durable. They are very much durable or not? Compared to steel structures, right? Compared to steel structures, they are very much durable or not? Yes. This masonry structures are very much durable compared to which one? Steel structures, you can say, right? Now, disadvantages. So, these are all the advantages you are having. And along with the advantages, you are having disadvantages also, no? Yes, these are all the disadvantages. Structurally very complex. What is the meaning of this structurally very complex? Easy to assess the behavior or it is not easy to assess the behavior? It is not easy to assess the structural behavior. It is easy to assess the structural behavior or it is not easy to assess the structural behavior exactly, right? It is not easy to assess the structural behavior exactly, you can say, right? Like that. Now, it is brittle. What is the disadvantage of this brittle? whenever it is brittle in nature, what is the meaning of this brittle? What this brittleness will do? It will result in this sudden failure, na? So means assessing means what? Understanding. Suppose Prakash, if you are having a beam, what you can understand? You can give guarantee that, on the beam only bending effect will be there. These loads are acting like this and only bending effect will be there on the beam. Whenever it is a slab, bending effect and shear effect, bending effect only we can consider like that, right? If it is a column, compression effect will be there. But if it is a masonry wall, can you give guarantee that only bending will come, only compression will come, only shear will come? Or it's a combination of all will come? Tell me. It's a combination of all. Can you able to assess which one is higher, which one is lesser easily? Can we able to guess which one is higher, which one is lesser exactly? Or it is not possible, Prakash? It is not easy to understand the behavior easily, na? So it is not easy to understand the behavior, na? So it is simple or it is complex structural behavior we are having. It is simple structural behavior or it is complex structural behavior we are having. It is a complex structural behavior we are having or not? Yes, it is complex structural behavior we are having, obviously, right? Next, heavy. Why it is heavy? Because suppose if you just observe whenever this is the concrete thickness, this is a concrete member having these dimensions and it is bearing some amount of load P, let us say. To bear the same load, right, this is your concrete, right, this is your which one, RCC, let us say. To bear the same load, we need to provide the same size of masonry or we need to provide very large size of the masonry to bear the same load. To bear this load P, RCC require this much dimensions and the masonry will require same dimensions or it will require larger dimensions, you can say. It will require same dimensions or it will require larger dimensions, you can say, all of it. It will require larger dimensions, no? Yes or no? More sizes means what? It is resulting in the heavy structures, obviously, no? Yes or no? Varun, correct, right? Varun, Prakash, correct, right? It will be resulting in which one? Masonry structures, more size, right? More sizes means what? Automatically, it will result in heavy structure, no? It will result in heavy structure, or not? Yes, it will result in heavy structure, more dimensions we require, right? Too many variables are there, right? In the analysis, what we need to do? Many variables we have to consider, right? Like that. So don't worry, in tomorrow's class, this terminology of this masonry and everything, the specifications of this masonry we'll see in tomorrow's class. Not tomorrow, day after tomorrow class, right? On 29th, don't worry, okay? Now, coming to this, masonry is a composite construction consisting of. So there are different types of this masonry units, right? What is that? Abode or adobe structures. Do you remember adobe structures we were discussed on the day? All of you. Do you remember all of you? Adobe structures, right? Adobe structures, do you remember? Sun-dried mud blocks, isn't it? Are we using any artificial material? Abode structures, adobe structures or abode structures means? Hello? Do you remember all of you? Abode or adobe structures, do you remember? Do you remember? Abode or adobe structures, if you just observe, sun-dried mud blocks, right? What we are doing? Just with respect to mud, what we are doing? Mud blocks will be creating, right? Mud blocks will be creating and will be placing one over the other and will be making them to dry under sunlight, sun heat. That's it, isn't it? And any artificial burning we are using or no artificial burning we are using? Is there any artificial burning we are using or no artificial burning we are using? No artificial burning we are using, no? Yes or no? The olden days huts also, if you just observe when you go to the villages, right? Nowadays, most of the villages are transformed. But previously, if you just observe 10 years before or 8 years before, 9 years before, if you just try to observe, there were huts you are having, no? Very poor people, if you just observe, they are very below poverty level also. So they will be having only huts, na? Huts with which one? That some leaves of these trees, they will be using it. And these walls of these huts are made up of which one? Sun-dried mud blocks only, na? Are they not sun-dried mud blocks? Yes, na? Even I have constructed these kind of walls in my childhood, actually, right? In our grandmother's house in the childhood, when we were in second class, third class, at the time, we used to do that, right? We used to do that, right? Like that. So, now, so that is sun-dried mud blocks we can use, right? Next one, stones we can use. Laterite blocks also we can use. Second type of construction is which one? Either we can use stones, laterite or blocks, right? Laterite and laterite block is also a stone, na? Laterite block is also a stone or not? Yes. Burnt clay bricks. So, this is the most commonly used or not? Which one is the most commonly used one, all of you? All-rounder. Which one is most commonly used now? At present, if you just observe, have you seen these abode structures anywhere? Have you seen these abode structures anywhere? People are using these abode structures anywhere now or nowhere people are using? Nowhere people are using, right? Why? Because at that time when we were in our childhood, at that time if you just observe, most of the children, they used to work, right? They used to work in their villages only. Nobody is fascinating about moving to city. Very less people are fascinating about to move to city, right? But you here in the villages, nobody is working. In the villages also, workers are not at all available, right? When workers are not at all available, is it possible to make these mud blocks and make them dry in the sun and construct them with that? It is impossible, right? So we need to get a ready-made, right? How can you get this ready-made? Burnt clay bricks are ready-made or not? Burnt clay bricks are ready-made or not? So these are the most commonly used bricks we are having or not? In our normal construction also, these are all the most commonly used one. Even if you are having these RCC structures, there the walls are constructed with what? There the walls are constructed with which one? These burnt clay bricks only, no? The red bricks we can say mostly, isn't it? These red bricks only we are using mostly or not? Yes, these red bricks only mostly we are using, you can say, right? Like that is a clear. Now, concrete blocks. Solid concrete blocks or hollow concrete blocks, right? Either you can go for which one? This is a solid type of these concrete blocks, you can see. Or you can go for which one? Hollow type of concrete blocks. Why hollow concrete blocks we are making? If you just observe. Why hollow concrete blocks we are making? If you just observe. Why these hollow concrete blocks? What is the reason? Do you require larger dimensions of the concrete to resist the same load as that of normal brick, or you require smaller dimensions of the concrete sufficient? Yes. One reason is what? Moment of inertia will be higher. Yes, that is fine. Moment of inertia is higher with which one? Less material, na? Only moment of inertia will be higher, or strength also will be higher, obviously. Only moment of inertia will be higher, or strength also will be higher in all aspects, right? Whether it is a shear strength or axial loaded strength or whatever it is a strength, strength also will be higher or not? Strength also will be higher, obviously, no? Yes or no? Strength also will be higher, obviously, or not? Yes, strength also will be higher, obviously, you can say like that. Yes or no? So, smaller dimensions will be required, right? So, both will be higher, you can say, right? Both will be higher. Strength will be higher, moment of inertia will be higher, even for smaller dimensions, right? Next one. What is another type of material we are using? Calcium silicate bricks we are using, na? Calcium silicate bricks we are using, right? These are...
Don't you think
These are made up of which one? Calcium silicate, you can say it. These are made up of which one? Calcium silicate, you can say it. Calcium silicate is the material we are using for this one. Okay, is that clear? Right. Now, stabilized mud blocks, right? So generally normal mud blocks, sun-dried mud blocks will be stable or not? Will they be stable? Normal sun-dried mud blocks, will they be stable or will not be stable? Can you able to make them in regular shape or we cannot make them regular shape, right? We cannot make them regular shape, but this one stabilized mud blocks means we'll be using which one? Some additional material. Additional materials are which one? Additional materials are used for this purpose, right? So additional materials like which one? Wire mesh and all these things, right? Sometimes we'll be using this grass also. Have you seen? While making these bricks, they'll be using this grass also. Grass leaves also they'll be using. Have you seen? These grass leaves also we can use for making it stable, right? Sometimes, okay? Or what we can use? Some mineral admixtures we can use, na? Or we can use which one? Some mineral admixtures for this purpose also, right? Some mineral admixtures also will be used for stabilizing this mud blocks, right? Next one is what? Fly ash gypsum blocks. Right? Fly ash which one? Right? Fly ash which one? Gypsum blocks will be using, right? Fly ash gypsum blocks will be using, right? Whenever you are using this fly ash gypsum blocks, right? These are all the masonry units based on which one? The material type, na? Isn't it? These are based on the material type only or not? Yes, these are all based on which one? Material type only, you can say like that. Is that clear, everyone? Now, mortar. So, what are the three elements you are having? Masonry is a composite construction consisting of, right? It is consisting of which one? Masonry unit, right? Masonry unit is the main part, na? Main part is your masonry unit or not? Yes, these bricks are these elements, right? Big elements of this masonry construction are masonry units, right? They are made up of which material? Second one is which one? Mortar. What is that mortar? Mortar is nothing but a binder of masonry units, na? Or bricks, you can say simple. In simple words, these masonry units are nothing but your which one? Bricks like arrangements, right? These bricks like arrangements will be just if you are keeping them as it is, can you able to have structural behavior? Or we need to bond them, we need to bind them together. We need to bind them together now. So for binding them together, what we require? We require a binder. That binder is called as your mortar. Which type of mortars will be taking? Mud mortar. Lime sand mortar, cement lime sand mortar, cement sand mortar, composite mortars like that. So composite mortars, right? Composite mortars means what? Cement, lime, soil, sand and additives we are using, right? Like that. These are all which one? These are all the types of what? Binding material or binder we are using, right? Is that clear? All of you. What are the list of binders we are using? Do you remember? We have seen H1, H2, M1, M2, L1, L2, H1, H2, M1, M2, L1, L2, those are related to which one? H1, H2, M1, M2, L1, L2. What are they? If you just remember, those are your mortar grades only, obviously, or not? Yes, those are your mortar grades only, obviously, you can say, right? Like that. No, sometimes we'll be providing the reinforcement also. So one is metallic, other one is which one? Non-metallic, right? What is the meaning of this metallic, you can say? Is it not steel or aluminium? Sometimes we'll be providing the steel reinforcement, sometimes we'll be providing the aluminium reinforcement, right? Those are your metallic, right? Non-metallic means what? grass, leaves, and sometimes you'll be using which one? This bark material. The tree's bark material we are having or not? Yes. Bamboo. Especially for this bamboo. Whenever you are having this bamboo, so this bamboo also will be having which one? Some ductile behavior or not? Some reinforcement is there or not? Yes, this bamboo also will be using for making the reinforcement, because right, like that. Okay, so and what is that? Based on the method employed in the production, three varieties of burnt clay bricks are available in India. So in India, how many types of the burnt clay bricks are available? Country brick, table molded brick, wire cut brick. What is that country brick, you can say? What is the meaning of this country brick, you can say? Are they made up of any standard table we are using, or we are just making normally? If we just observe in some of the villages, these people will suddenly come and they will be taking this agriculture land for lease for 1 year or 6 months, and there itself they will be creating the bricks and they will be burning there itself. Now, have you seen that, all of you? Have you seen that, all of you? Even in our village, we have observed many times, right? They'll be just come to some particular village and they'll be taking this agriculture land, and that clay they'll be using, and there itself they'll be manufacturing the bricks, and they'll be arranging all these bricks in the form of this pyramid, and they'll be inserting some wood or whatever it is, timber or whatever it is, a burning material, and they'll be burning it. Have you seen that, all of you? Have you seen that, all of you? Seen or not seen? Hello? Yes or no? Right? So now, so if we just observe, what is that, a table molded bricks, that is country brick, means what? It is normally made, right? Table molded brick means what? What is the meaning of this table molded brick? This is nothing but your industry making, na? Industry made, right? Industry made, you can say, right? Industry which one? Made, you can say, right? Industry made, you can say, right? So what is the meaning of this table molded? So we will be having a table like this, and on this table what you are having? We are having these molds. Molds are created already. These molds are created already, you can see it. These molds are already created. What we'll do? We'll just fill the bricks here. So we'll just fill which one? We'll just fill the mason. We'll just fill which one? That clay here, right? In this we'll be filling the clay. 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 Like that we'll be filling the clay inside all these gaps. So this mold will be having how much dimension? Same as that of your bricks. Brick dimension required, right? Like that. So in your building materials, you might have studied what are the dimensions of this brick. Here it is not required. Don't worry. So we'll be filling them, right? After that, what we'll do? After filling on this table, these molds are there, like this. And after filling the clay in this mold, what we'll be doing? We'll be just taking them outside, right? We'll be just taking them outside, and we'll be just burning them, or we'll be making them to dry under sunlight. Yes, na? That is what we'll do, right? So after filling them, we'll be just reversing it. So that what will happen? So after smooth finishing on the surface and all these things, right, what will happen? What you can do after smooth finishing? We can just take them for burning only, no? So now, we can just take them for burning only or not? Yes, we can just take them for what? Burning only. It will be like this. Yes, na? Right. So now, what you can do? So we'll be filling this in the mold, and after that, what we can do? We can just reverse it and finish. First, finish it off smoothly and fill it completely under wet condition. Right? Under wet condition. Right? That clay will be mixed with water and fill it in this, right? Fill it in this and vibrate it, right? Vibrate it, right? Whenever you are vibrating, what will happen? Is there any, if at all there are any gaps present, those gaps will be filled or not? What is the purpose of this vibration of this table? If any gaps are present inside the filling, they will be cleared off or not? Those gaps will be cleared off. You can say it, those gaps will be cleared off and perfect dimension will be formed, right? Then you just reverse it and you try to remove this mold with the table. So that what will happen? Or sometimes if it is an industry, what you will do? We'll keep it as it is, and at the bottom separation plate will be there, and we'll be just taking this plate outside, right? We'll be just taking this plate outside, right? Yeah. We can just bring this plate down, so that what will happen? This molding will be there as it is, but bricks you are present. You'll be having bricks on which one? You'll be having bricks on which one? This plate you can say, right? So these bricks you can burn like that. Is that clear? Either you can just reverse it for placing somewhere, or so we'll be having these molds are there, and bottom detached plate will be there. We just bring this plate down, so that what will happen, only bricks will be present, right? Either way you can do it. Is that clear? What is the meaning of this table molded bricks, all of you? Is that clear, the meaning of this table molded bricks, all of you? Everyone, is that clear? Na? Table molded bricks, is that clear, all of you? Yes, na? Now wire cut bricks, right? What is the meaning of this wire cut brick, you can say? What is the meaning of this wire cut brick, you can say? What you will do is, you will be having this kind of arrangement, na? You'll be having this kind of arrangement, right? You'll be having this kind of arrangement, right? What you can do on this arrangement, right? We will be filling this. Just a minute. We may not be filling it completely because, right. So up to this, we'll be filling it completely, isn't it? So you will be filling it completely, right? Whenever you are filling it completely, what will happen? If you are filling it completely, right? If you are filling it completely and just make a box or cake of this one, and what we will do? After that, we will be cutting this with wires, na? What we will do? Instead of molds, what you can do? Instead of molds, what you can do? We can just take a wire here and just pull this wire down, so that brick will be cut, na? Isn't it? And we'll be just taking the same wire here and we'll be placing it here and we'll be cutting it with the wire. And we'll be taking the same wire here and we'll be cutting it, right? And we'll be taking the same wire here and we'll be cutting it, right? Like that. So here also we'll be taking that wire, here also we'll be taking that wire and cutting, right? Is that clear? Wire cut brick, table molded brick and country brick. The differences, is that clear, everyone, all of you? Is that clear, everyone? Yes, na? So here what you are seeing, masonry units, right? Different materials we are using for which one? Masonry units are bricks, you can say. And binder material is which one? Different types of the mortars or binder materials we can see, right? Reinforcements, right? What are the different types of the reinforcements we have to use, right? Like that. So based on the method of production, based on the method of production of your bricks, these are the three methods you can have, right? Country brick, table molded and wire cut, right? Like that. Is that clear? Where the remaining material is wasted? Why remaining material is wasted here? If we just observe, have you seen that making of pots and everything? In the wet condition only we are cutting, na, here. Prakash, in the wet condition only we are cutting here, na. So whenever you are cutting in the wet condition, what will happen? See, this is your block, let us say, right? This is your block we have made, right? And what we are doing, this block of required dimension only we are making, right? So that we can make some 10 number of bricks or 5 number of bricks. According to that dimension only exactly you make, right? You cut here, this will become one brick. You cut here, this will become second brick. You cut here, third brick. You cut here, fourth brick. This will become fifth brick, right? You will be manufacturing this block or cake to the required dimensions only, na? If you are producing this for any dimension of your wish, then there is a possibility of material wastage. But if you are manufacturing this block or cake to the required dimensions, do you have any loss of material or no loss of material? There will not be any loss of material if you are manufacturing properly. No? Is that clear? Right. So this is a multi-storied unreinforced masonry tower at Thanjavur, right? If you just observe it, this kind of building. It is which one? Multi-story building only? Yeah. Multi-story building unreinforced, right? Is there any reinforcement? No. So it is in Thanjavur, Tamil Nadu. It is there, right? Like that. So this kind of structures are there, right? Unreinforced masonry arches and aqueducts. So like that. So these are all there or not? Arches and aqueducts, all these things. These are all reinforced or unreinforced, you can say. Unreinforced only, no? These are all your unreinforced only or not? Yes. So like that, this is also an example. So no. So Monadnock building, Chicago, right? In Chicago, this 1891, this building also was constructed of masonry, right? 1891 means at that time concrete is that much famous or concrete was not that much famous? At the time, concrete was not that much famous, no? Concrete was not that much famous and masonry we were using mostly, right? This is also 16-storied load-bearing masonry, right? So, it is load-bearing masonry means what? It is load-bearing masonry, right? What is the meaning of this load-bearing masonry? All loads are being which one resisted, you can say, right? All loads are being which one resisted, right? All loads are being resisted, you can say, right? Like that. Is it clear? So now, yeah, it is very, very weaker, right? It is very, very weaker. Yes. So this columns also there, right? Columns also made up of which one? These columns also made up of which one? Is there any separate column you are providing here in this Thanjavur structure? Are there any separate columns you are providing in this Thanjavur structure? There are no separate columns you are providing. No? Here also are you providing, so this looks like a columns only. This looks like a columns only, but these are of which columns you can say? These are of masonry columns only, no? These are all masonry columns only, no? These are all masonry, right? Here there are no columns, but here you are having columns, right? These are all your columns or compression members only. Here we are having these columns like this, but they are made up of which one? Masonry only, right? Like that. So like that we can have these kind of structures, you can see, right? Now coming to this, masonry is weaker than the brick. Okay, in load bearing means what? All loads are resisted by masonry only. Okay, Prakash, all loads are resisted by which one? Masonry only, right? So this masonry column, right? Yeah, this masonry columns only will be there, masonry bricks only will, masonry walls only will be there, and walls will resist the loads, right? What is the meaning of load bearing? Walls will resist the load. Normally in our framed structure, right? Normally in our framed structure, if you just observe, in this framed structure, loads will be transferred onto the masonry or loads will not be transferred onto the masonry mainly. Are these loads will be transferred onto the masonry or whatever the load comes, it will be transferred onto this beam, from this beam to this column. From this column to this footing, directly they will be transferred, right? Load will not be transferred onto this brick wall. But here if you just observe, what you are having? Only what you can say? Only the brick walls plus RCC slabs we are having, right? Only the brick walls plus RCC slabs we are having, right? So if you just observe in our temples, are they not examples of this masonry structures, stone masonry structures? even though you are having this multi stories there in old temples, if you just observe, they will not be having there are no columns. Sometimes there will be, sometimes columns will be providing, right? Like that, it is depending upon the situation. We provide columns, we may not provide columns, right? What you can do, so here wall we will construct. Listen, yes, these are all your walls, these are your door openings, let us say. And what you can do here, and what you can do here, you can just make a slab here. So whenever you are making a slab here, the loads will be transferred onto which one? No beams, let us say. Same, right? Prakash, load bearing walls and load bearing masonry are same, right? Walls are generally made up of masonry only, no? See, walls are made up of masonry only, no? Walls are made up of masonry only, no? So, if you are talking about masonry structure, means there are the main structural elements are masonry elements only, okay? So, here if you just observe, this is your slab you are having, right? This is your slab you are having, RC slab, right? This is made up of which one? RC slab, whatever it is, right? So here all these walls are made up of which one? All these walls are made up of which one? Masonry walls only, no? Now tell me, the load is transferred from slab to the masonry walls directly only, no? Is there any columns and beams you are having? No beams and no columns, no? Are there any columns and beams you are having, or no beams and no columns, you can say? No beams and no columns, you can say, right? No beams and no columns means the load is directly transferred, right? So this is your slab, let us say. Here directly you are having the wall, here directly you are having the wall, here directly we are having the wall, here directly below this slab you are having the wall, right? No beams and no columns, right? So are these walls load bearing or not? No. These masonry walls will be of load bearing or not load bearing? Tell me. When load is directly transferred on to, from slab to these walls, they are load bearing or they are not load bearing? They are load bearing definitely, right? Because they have to take the load from the slab. Yes, na? Is that clear? Yes, correct, right? Non-load bearing walls means we were having which one? Columns and beams. So this framework itself will transfer the loads, no? Whatever the load applied from this slab, that slab loads will be transferred onto the beam, from beam to column, column to this bottom column to footing. Yes, na? So, is there any load transfer in between to the walls? Is there any load transfer in between to the brick walls, all of you? There is no load transfer to the brick walls, na? Yes, na? There is no load transfer to the brick walls if it is a framed structure having beams and columns. So, brick walls are not resisting which one? Any load. But here if you just observe, there are no beams and no columns means entire load must be resisted by this brick wall masonry only, na? Entire load must be resisted by this brick wall masonry only or not? Yes, like that. Is that clear? Now do you get the clarity? No? Do you get the clarity? So this is which one? These are your masonry units, right? This red color top one, this red color bottom one, or which one? Masonry units, you can say. And what is this one? Mortar, right? So what is this element, you can say? This element connecting this top brick and bottom brick is called as your mortar, you can say, right? Now, what is it you have to identify? Masonry is weaker than the brick and weaker than the mortar. You have to be careful, right? Original brick strength is higher, but masonry structure strength will be lesser. Okay? If you just observe one example, the block strength will be 40 Newton per mm square. Mortar type H1 strength is 8 Newton per mm square. Then the masonry strength is only about 3.05 Newton per mm square, right? Like that. So the masonry strength is only 3.05 Newton per mm square, right? Why it is like that, tell me? Why it is like that, tell me. What is the reason, anyone? Suppose if you are having only what? Brick. And if you are applying some load here like this, what will happen? There is full resistance, right? But if you are applying some lateral load onto this brick, do you guarantee that it will be separated or it will not be separated easily? Typical masonry prisms, right? So it will be getting separated easily or it will not be getting separated easily? One brick to other brick, right? One brick to other brick, the separation will be easy or difficult, all of you? Hello? Somebody? The separation will be easy or difficult? Will separate now? Will separate now? Now tell me, will it be capable of resisting this bending? Buckling? No, it cannot be capable of resisting this bending buckling. No, single brick if you consider, it will be resisting more buckling compared to this group of bricks. Isn't it? Single brick itself will resist more amount of bending compared to this group of bricks. Isn't it all of you? Yes, that is what the meaning of this one, right? Masonry is weaker than the block, weaker than individual brick, right? Like that. Now, masonry walls, slenderness and eccentricity. So, stocky wall, eccentric load reduces the strength, right? Isn't it? Stocky wall means what? What is the meaning of this stocky wall? It is having the larger length or it is having the smaller length only? Stocky wall means it is having the larger length or smaller length only? Smaller length only we are having. And instead of applying the load exactly at the center, we are applying the load at which one? With some eccentricity, right? What does it mean? This is your stocky wall only. This is your centroidal axis. Yes. So, the load is applied at which location? At E distance from the CG, right? Whenever it is applied at E distance from the CG, so it will result in which one? That eccentricity will be resulting in what? That eccentricity will result in which one? What it will do? It will require which one? It will create which one? Additional bending effects, right? It will create which one? Additional bending effects, right? These additional bending effects, what they will do? They will reduce the axial load strength, na? They will reduce the strength, obviously, or not? Yes, they will reduce the strength. They will reduce the strength, obviously, right? So now, if you just observe this slender wall, what this slender wall will do? What will come because of this slender? Additional which one? Buckling will be created, na? Yes, an additional buckling will be created or not? Yes. Slender means what? Very larger. Very larger length means under the action of this point load, it will be subject to buckling easily or not? Yes, it will be subject to buckling easily, right? Like that. So, slender wall, eccentric load much more reduces the strength, right? Eccentricity itself will reduce the strength. Slenderness ratio further reduction. Slenderness ratio and eccentricity both are present together. Automatically, they will be resisting much more. They will be reducing the strength by larger extent, na? They will be reducing the strength by larger extent or not? Yes, they will be reducing the strength by which one? Larger extent, you can say, right? Like that. Now, the last part for today, structural wall have three functions, right? What is that? First one is vertical load in compression. Vertical compression, right? Why this vertical compression will come mainly? What is this vertical compression mainly will come? because of this externally applied loads, right? Dead load, live load, dead load and externally applied live load, both together will cause vertical compression or not? Yes, both will cause vertical compression, right? It has to resist out of plane bending from eccentric vertical loads, that is gravity loads, and or transverse loads such as wind loads and earthquake loads. Whenever this wind load is acting on this, whenever this wind load is acting like this or earthquake load is acting like this, it will be subjected to movement like this, na, isn't it? Your structure will be moving like this, right? Whenever your structure is moving like this, obviously what will happen? What will happen? Other loads also will come, na? So no, other this bending effect, buckling effect, all these things will come into picture, na? Yes. So in plane, so out of plane, this bending and these kinds of things also they need to resist, right? Next one, they resist in plane forces, right? Out of plane forces like bending, in plane forces like which one? In plane shear and in plane bending attracted by the masonry buildings as a whole. Okay, so from the other parts of the masonry buildings, right? From the other part of this masonry buildings, this kind of in-plane forces also will be getting, right? Generally, which one? Only first one is possible, right? Whenever you are going for this masonry as a structure, this one, second one. Masonry as a structure, but with more sophistications, this third one will be going for, right? Like that. Is that clear, everyone? Whatever we discussed till now, is that clear, everyone? It has to resist, right? Because we'll be having some bending, na? Prakash. We will be having some bonding between this top brick, second brick, third brick, fourth brick, fifth brick, na? So they will be resisting more amount of bending or they will be resisting only little bit amount of bending? They will resist more amount of bending or they will resist a small amount of bending if this kind of bending is occurring? Little bit of bending can be resisted or not? Yes. Suppose if lateral force is also acting, it can be resisting little bit of compression, na? Because of the bonding between the top brick and bottom brick by means of which one? This binder material. Okay? Is that clear, everyone? So these are all the things we'll see in tomorrow's class. Don't worry. Write this earthquake resistant design. So there is an important announcement. KP sir, myself and Praveen Kulkarni sir will be going to start new plus courses, right? New batch will be going to start, right? New batch we are going to start, right? Like that. Is that clear? These advantages, benefits of which one? Plus subscription, this is a fee structure, these are the benefits of iconic subscription, these are fee structure. Okay, this is my profile, you can follow me at which, right, like that. So all of you, thank you. So you remember that from May 5th onwards that new batch is going to start mainly for English language, right? Mainly in which one? English language, you can say, right? Like that. So shall I close the session, all of you?